Hello, this is Mia Wood, Associate Professor of Philosophy in the Philosophy and Sociology Department at Pierce College. Today we're going to talk about translating sentences into standard form for categorical propositions. We do this so as to organize the logical structure of the sentence more precisely to make the logical structure of the sentence clear. So we'll cover the following topics: standard form, quantity and quality, several non-standard formulations, and identifying subject and predicate classes and articulating them in standard form. Here are the steps that we're going to go through. You don't necessarily have to do them in this order, but it helps to give you a step-by-step sequence for taking ordinary language sentences and translating them into standard form. So you could start by identifying the quantity of the proposition. Is it universal or particular? You can identify the quality of the proposition. Is it affirmative or negative? Identify the classes, that is, the subject and predicate class, and make sure that each class is articulated as a noun or noun phrase. First, let's review standard form for categorical propositions. Each of these is a claim type, so any sentence that is true or false can be resolved into one of these four forms. There's the universal affirmative, the universal negative, the particular affirmative, and the particular negative. Notice that there are a couple of features that each of these claim types share in common. They each have a subject and predicate class, represented respectively by capital S and capital P, and they each have a copula, represented by the conjugation of the verb to be, word are. All right, now let's talk about the concepts quantity and quality. Quantity refers to the universal or particular status of a given proposition. In other words, it tells us how much is involved in a particular claim. Quality refers to the affirmative or negative status of a proposition. Let's look at some examples. Every dog is an animal is a universal affirmative claim. None of the students enjoyed the exam is a universal negative claim. Many pit bulls have a bad reputation is a particular affirmative claim. And not every cake is delicious is a particular negative claim. Remember, we want to take every ordinary language sentence that is either true or false and resolve it into one of the four types of categorical claim in standard form. Right now, these examples are of sentences that are not in standard form, but what we did was identify the quantity and the quality. Let's look at some other non-standard formulations. Universal affirmatives include some of the following ordinary language expressions: wherever, whenever, whomever, whatever, any, and so forth. Universal negatives include the following expressions: never, none, not even one, all are not, no one, etc. Particular affirmatives include expressions like many, most, quite a few, several, a lot, and so forth. Lastly, particular negative claims involve formulations such as not all, most aren't, not every. If you can identify these and similar expressions, you'll be able to identify both the quantity and quality of any sentence that is either true or false. Now let's look at the subject and predicate class of a given proposition. The order of the proposition's elements in standard form are quantity, the subject class, the copula, and the predicate class. Here's an example. All helicopters are flying machines. All is the quantity. Helicopters is the subject class. The copula is the conjugation of the verb to be, in this case the word are. And the predicate class is flying machines. Let's go back now to our steps for translating. Remember, we identify the quantity, universal or particular. In this case, we have the sentence, most introverts aren't friendly. Most tells us that we're dealing with a particular claim. Now, the quality. Notice that we have a negative. Most introverts are not friendly. Next, let's identify the classes. We have the class of introverts and the class of friendly things. Remember, what we want to do when we put our argument, or I'm sorry, when we put or translate our sentence into standard form, is we make sure that each of our classes is articulated by a noun or a noun phrase. In this case, then, we have most introverts aren't friendly people. So the final formulation for this particular sentence will look as follows. Remember, the sentence we just looked at is a particular negative. The original non-standard form sentence is most introverts aren't friendly. Standard form is some introverts are not friendly people. I hope this brief tutorial has been helpful.